Hi, I'm Rami Tamimi. Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a Civil 3D drawing by dedicating description keys for your points and importing the points that you collected in the field. Now, a while back, I made a video describing how to do a topographic survey. If you haven't seen that video, go ahead and click on the eye in the corner. This is how we perform a topographic survey, and it is the data set that we will be using for this project. Once you've watched that, come back to this video, and I'll show you how to process this data. Now, after you've exported the project, you should have either a text file or a CSV file. Now, a CSV file can be opened in Excel, and that's probably the most user-friendly file format that you're going to want to use. Here we have our CSV file with all of our points. Remember, these shots are the concrete shots, these are the back of curb shots, gutter shots, light poles, and we went and shot in 135 points. Now we're going to move these points over here to the side, and I've got Civil 3D open. What we're going to do is just start up a new drawing, and you're going to want to select the template that you want to use. If you don't have a template, you can just go on Google and download a template off the internet. This will include different icons, different text styles, and things that you can edit, but it's definitely a lot more difficult to do this without having a template. I'll go ahead and link below in the description a template that you can use, but you're also welcome to find your own template, or if you work for a company and they have a template, you can use their template. So I've got my template right here. This can either be a DWG file or a DWT file. I haven't really seen DWS, but I guess you can use that as well. But these are the two popular file formats. So mine just happens to be a DWG. So I'm gonna click on that and I'm gonna open. Now we're going to update the description keys for our project. When we bring in our points, they will automatically change the symbols and we don't have to change them manually. To do this, go ahead and select the tool space option. Make sure that the settings tab is enabled. And in the tool space, you're gonna go over to points, description key sets, right click and pick new. We're going to create a new description key set. So I'm gonna call these Rami's keys. You can name this whatever you want, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to select Rami's keys, right clicking and selecting edit keys. All right, now we have our description key editor. And what we wanna do is put in all of the codes that we use in the field and assign different symbols and labels for them so that they automatically come in proper. So the first description I see here is C1, which was concrete one. What I'll do is I'll put the code as C. And since we're using a lot of different numbers, I'm just going to put an asterisk right here. And so that way, anything that comes after C will be considered under the same code. Under styles, we're going to then select what kind of style we want to use. I think we should just use a normal tick mark, so I'm just going to select standard, okay? And for the point label style, I'm going to display point number, elevation, and description. All right, and now we're going to select the layer, and you can pick something from the pre-existing layers. That's totally fine. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to create some layers for us. So I'm gonna click on new, and I wanna name this layer concrete. So I'm just gonna say conc. The color, we can probably make it, let's do yellow. Okay. Line type, continuous is fine. Line weight, we can keep it the way it is. And I'm gonna say okay. So this is my conc layer. I want that layer, okay. All right, now that we've done that, we're gonna go and create another description key. To create another one, you're gonna select the last one, click new. Type in what kind of description it is. We're gonna do now back of curb. We want the back of curb to probably have the same standard tick. The point style, I want it to have point number, elevation, and description. Okay. The layer, I'm going to create a new layer to call it back of curb. I want the color to be green. I'm gonna say okay, okay. Create a new layer. We're gonna call this one GU since it's gutter, standard. Standard, point elevation description, create a new layer. I'm gonna call this gutter. Let's make the color like a gray. Okay, okay. We have light pole. Light pole. Now for a light pole, we don't want to just use a standard X. We're actually going to want to create a light pole symbol. Now you might actually have the light pole already inside of your description keys. If not, you can go ahead and create a new one under information. I'm just going to call this light pole. Under the marker, I'm going to use one of the symbols, and I think if I just go here, they probably have it. Yep, there it is, light pole. Just add that. Okay, for the point style, I only want the description and the point number, so point number and description. Okay, and I'm going to create a new layer and call it light pole. Once you've gotten all your description keys in, you can go ahead and check off this box. All right, for the next part, we're going to bring in the points that we collected in the field. To do this, you're going to go to the Insert tab. You're going to select Points from File. You're then going to click the Add button. All right, and then I'm going to select the Topo Survey CSV file. Okay, everything has loaded in. Now, the way that you export your points is going to vary. The proper way to do it is to export the point number first, then the northing, then the easting, then the elevation, and then the description. Depending on how the points are separated, either it be commas or a space, will also influence on what kind of filtering. My points are filtered through comma delineation, and I have the point number, northing, easting, elevation, and then description. So I'm going to select that. I'm going to go ahead and hit OK. If you press the scroll key twice, it'll take you to all of your points. And would you look at that? All of our points come in perfectly. Now they seem a little bit small, and that's because we don't have a scale set yet for our project. Come to the bottom right of your screen, select the 1:1 scale and select custom. I'm gonna go ahead and click the word add. And depending on how big your project is, will dictate what the scale should be. I'm gonna go ahead and take a guess and just say 1 inch is equal to 40 feet. So then my paper units are 1 and my drawing units will be 40. I'll go ahead and click OK. OK again, and then I will set my scale to 1:40. Ah, yeah, see that looks a little too big. We'll go back to custom. We can then either edit this one or we can add a new one. Let's do a quarter of that. 1 inch is equal to 10 feet. So one paper unit is the same as 10 drawing units. Okay, okay. Change our scale to 1:10, and there we go. Yeah, that looks a little bit more reasonable. There are some points that are on top of each other, but we can move those, so that's not that big of a deal. If you watched one of my previous videos, I explained how you can bring an aerial image into your drawing. Bringing in this aerial image will ensure that your points are coming in the correct spot. The function that I'm referring to is the online map, which is found under the geolocation tab. Once I've signed into my Autodesk 360 account and selected the coordinate system that I'm working in, I can turn on my map and see that my points are falling into the correct spot. This is exactly where I want them to be. They're coming in nicely, and I can start doing my work from here. And there you have it. That is how you can create description keys for your project and import your points from your field collection. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you found it informative, please be sure to like the video. I'll be putting out new videos in the future. And with that, I'll see you guys next time.